us move towards the next characteristic feature of a living organism. So the first character, that is, every living organism has a definite cell structure, isn't it? So second characteristic feature of a living organism. So every living organism, either it is a unicellular or multicellular, must possess metabolism. Then understand what is the meaning of a metabolism. So the definition of a metabolism, as I already told that, it is a sum total of all reactions. Means, take for example, in our body, several reactions at a time. At a time, several reactions are going on. The best example I can give you, that is respiration and digestion. Respiration, digestion, these are the two examples where the different types of reactions are going on in our body. Okay, it is the sum total of all reactions. So it is a network of reactions. So every living organism exhibits a network of reactions which are taking place in the living organism within the cell by an interaction of a specific type of molecules. Okay, so by the interaction of the molecules, the different kinds of a network of reactions are taking place in a cell. So that means every living organism exhibits metabolism. Totally the different kind of reactions, okay, those are known as metabolism. But if we consider metabolism, it is of two types once again. So there are two kinds of metabolism reactions we come across. The very first one is anabolism, catabolism. So let us know the meaning of anabolism. Anabolism is also a kind of reaction. Catabolism is also a kind of reaction. But what is anabolism? What is the meaning of anabolism? Let us understand. So the constructive reactions are known as anabolism. The best example for anabolism is the photosynthesis. In plants, you might be knowing, the photosynthesis takes place. So for the photosynthesis, what is required? For the photosynthesis to carry, the plants require carbon dioxide, water, sunlight, chlorophyll. By using these molecules, inorganic molecules, they prepare food material, glucose, and they store in the leaf, isn't it? So store in the root. So all those reactions coming under anabolism. Anabolism is a constructive process where building up of the molecules. Building up means construction of the process is called as anabolism. So another one is, what is catabolism then? So destruction of the destruction reactions. The best example for a catabolic is a breakdown reaction is a respiration or digestion. You know that how we respire. So due to the glucose. So when a glucose molecule with the help of oxygen, the oxidation takes place, breakdown of the glucose takes place, as a result carbon dioxide, water and energy. Okay, so this is a destructive process. Why we are calling it as destructive or breaking down reaction? Because the complex food particles, complex molecules of glucose, they undergo oxidation, they are broken down, and they are going to release carbon dioxide and water. So it is a destructive process. So through this phenomena, we get the energy through the respiration process. So both anabolism and metabolism, catabolism, togetherly known as metabolism. So every living organism must exhibit this character. The best example I told you, the growth, reproduction, consciousness, and other characteristic features are all the, they are the result of this metabolism only. If the metabolism is not occurring in the body of the cell or organism, then the growth, reproduction and other characteristic features are not going to take place in the living organism. Now next character is growth. Yes. Now we understand what is growth. Everybody know growth is, simply we define growth is nothing but increase in the size of the organism. Okay, so how the growth of the organism takes place? Okay, the growth takes place simply by cell division. Yes, you know that at a school level already you have learned. See what kind of cell division? The growth, let us define what is growth then. Growth is nothing but, it is a permanent irreversible process. It is an irreversible process. As a result of growth, as a result of cell division, the increase in the size of the organism takes place, or increase in the biomass of the organism takes place. Okay. So, if we consider growth in the plants, if we consider growth in the plant. It takes place in the growing plants like meristematic tissue, and it takes place throughout its life. Throughout its life, the plant exhibits growth. But it is, in case of animals, the growth is going to occur only up to certain stage only. After a certain stage, the growth is going to stop. So whatever, after that, if the growth occurs, if the cell division occurs, it only replaces the old cell, lost cells. To remove the old cells only, the cell division occurs. Overall, here growth is nothing but it is a permanent, irreversible process in which the increase in the size of the organism or increase in the biomass of the organism taking place, and it is a permanent process. Okay, and this is continuous process in plants. It is going to occur in animals only up to certain stage only. Okay, so growth, that is growth occurs because of the cell division. Okay, it is going to occur because of the cell division, especially mitotic cell division. So later in classes you will be learning what is cell division, what type of cell divisions are there, what are the significances, all those we shall discuss in the forthcoming classes. So growth is also one of the important feature of the living organism. Now coming to reproduction, we know that every living organism reproduce. Then what is reproduction? Reproduction is nothing but the organism, a mature organism, capable of giving birth to its young one. Okay, then why the reproduction is required? Is it necessary for living organism? Of course it is necessary. Why? Because if reproduction does not take place by the living organism, the continuity of the life does not exist. Hence, to continue its race, to continue its generation, the reproduction is necessary. Means reproduction is also one of the defining characteristic feature of the living organism. And we study different kind of asexual reproduction, sexual reproduction in lower organism and higher organism, and taking by different examples. But take for example, Hydra is there, algae, fungi, bryophyte, human. In different organism, different types of reproduction they exist. But what kind of animals? Some organisms do not reproduce. For example, I tell you, sterile couple. See, the sterile couple cannot reproduce. And there is one more example, that is mule. Okay, we will discuss about all these animals later. Mule cannot reproduce, means it is a sterile. Sterile couple also cannot reproduce. It doesn't mean that they are not living one. They are cannot reproduce. Mule cannot reproduce. It doesn't mean that they are non-living. They are living. But this is the exception where sterile couple, mule cannot reproduce. So what is reproduction? It is the production of or giving birth to the young ones is known as reproduction. Last, finally, consciousness. We know that every living organism, either unicellular or multicellular, or either lower organism or high organism, they undergo consciousness. What is consciousness then? It is the ability of the organism to sense the environment. You know, the environment poses different stimuli. There are different stimuli are there. Physical, chemical, biological stimuli are there. Unless and until these stimulus are produced by the environment, the living organism cannot sense it. Through our sense organs, eyes, nose, ear, we can sense the environment. We can feel the environment. So whether it is a bitter, whether it is a sweet, we can hear the sound, we can see the vision, we can see the sight with the help of sensory organs only. It is all because of the consciousness. So consciousness is one of the living character, defining characteristic feature of a living organism. So the ability to sense, to feel the environment due to the stimuli. The stimuli may be anything, I told you. So these are the most important living characteristic features, defining characteristic features of a living organism. So we shall stop.